Just come and let us prepare our hearts to worship the Lord this morning. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We glorify your name, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord Jesus. We come here to approach your throne, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we magnify your name, Lord Jesus. You alone are worthy to be praised, God. We worship you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord, we cross your throne. Oh, we are nobody. Oh, we are nobody. Oh, Ramashala, Baba, 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 Yana, Mashiala, Baba, Baba, Yaki. Oh, yes, we worship you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Worship God. Yes, Lord. Oh, Rabba, Baba, Baba, Shaka, Baba, Baba, hallelujah. By grace alone, somehow I stand where we were in just fear to tread. In white by redeeming love, yes, Lord. Before the throne of God above, he pulls me close beneath your hands into his everlasting arms. Yes, Lord. Where condemnation grips my heart, yes, Lord. And say the dance I am the Lord is here. Oh, praise the Lord. Who praise the one who fights for me and shield my soul eternally. Holy, I approach your and risen sun, more beauty than this world has known. I'm face to face with love in the sound. His purpose for this righteous man. Oh, thousand years, a time. I'm not enough to bring it through. Only I approach your throne, yes, Lord. Blameless now and running gone. By your blood I come. Welcome as your Lord into the earth. Thank you, Abba Father. Lord Jesus, we come this morning, Father, as we gather here, Father. We just want just to uphold, Lord Jesus, our country, Malaysia, Father God. Thank you, Father God, for your blessing, your power, Father God, from the north to the south, to the east to the west, Father God, Lord Jesus, upon our country, Malaysia, Father God. What you have done, we just want to say thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father God, we pray, Father God, Lord Jesus, there will be a freedom, Father God, Lord Jesus, where is your gospel to be shared, Father God, in this country, Lord Jesus. And we believe, Father God, Lord Jesus, many more, Father God, they will come and turn themselves before you, Lord Jesus, because you are the way, the truth, and the life, Father God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, thank you, Father God. We just say thank you for all you've done, Lord Jesus. And also, Lord Jesus, and we never forget, Father God, to bless your nation, Israel, Father God, Lord Jesus. Oh, thank you, Father God, for your covering, for your protection, Father God, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. And they will come to know you too, Father God, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you for your covering, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are so worthy to be praised, Father God, Lord Jesus. And also, we want to just thank you, Father God, Lord Jesus, for your sweet presence that fills us here. Fill this temple. Oh, fill this place, O God. Oh, Rabba Baba Shaka, atmosphere of worship, Father God. Oh, Rabba Kaba Kaba Kaganda. Oh, this is our first time, Father God, we gather in your house, God, to continue to worship you, Father God. Hallelujah. We give you glory and honor, Father God, this morning, Father God. Oh, we welcome you, Holy Spirit. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord Jesus. Magnify your name alone. Are worthy to be praised, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Good morning. Shalom, church.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord.
I gotta give His love endures forever. For His good is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, Lord. Sing praise. With a mighty hand and outstretched arm, His love endures forever. For the thunder has been reborn. Love and you forever. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever God is faithful, yes Lord. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever and ever. Forever. Yes Lord, your love and your forever God. Just want to give thanks for that. that he signed. His love endures forever. By the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever, Lord, forever. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever and ever. Forever. Yes, Lord, forever. Your love and yours forever, God. Oh, God, we worship you. His love and yours forever. His love and yours forever. His love and yours forever. Forever. His love, God. His love and yours forever. His love and yours. Love and yours forever. Oh, forever, Lord, is love and yours. Love and yours forever. Is love and yours forever. Is love and yours forever. Forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever and ever. Forever. Hallelujah, praise you. Amen, yes, Lord. Amen, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give thanks to you, God. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thousands and thousands. Oh, yeah,
Hallelujah. Oh God, worship you, Jesus. Oh Rababa Shara Baba Badi. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father God. Oh Rababa Baba Shaka Badi. Yeshala Baba Baba Baba. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father God.
Oh, we worship you, God. Thank you, Father God, Lord Jesus. Your word will minister to us, Father God, this morning, Lord Jesus. A passion, Father God, for your name, Lord Jesus. A desire, Father God, for your name, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you glory and honor. You are worthy to be praised, Father God. In wonderful name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. A very good morning to each one of you. I trust that you have had a good week and trust that you have been enjoying the favor of the Lord. Now this morning, before we get into the word, I would like each one of us to unite our hearts together, and we want to pray for Malaysia and also for Israel and also for the pandemic situation in our country. All right, let's unite our hearts together. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. Wonderful Jesus. We look to you, God, because you are a God who is alive. We thank you, Father, we can gather together this morning, and we look to you and we ask you, Father, especially for the nation of Malaysia. We thank you, Lord, that you are in charge. You are sovereign over this nation. We pray, Lord Jesus, every part of the leadership, the authorities, Lord, we pray that you will minister to them, Father, that they will rise up, Lord, and be God-fearing with the fear of the Lord. They will run this nation with righteousness, Father. We pray, Lord, for the COVID situation. Lord, you know, Lord, every situation that's going on in this COVID pandemic, we pray, Lord, and we come against every variant of this COVID, and we pray, Lord, that every part of the COVID virus will be completely destroyed in the name of Jesus. There will not be any more mutations of the virus. There will not be any more virus, Lord, I pray. Lord, I pray, Lord, every part of this nation, Father, that you will minister to the people who are already suffering, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that every one of them at this time will look to you, Father, and you will reach down and touch them, because you are the God of love, you are a God of grace, and truly, Lord, we thank you, Father, that you are a God of comfort. Minister to the people, Lord, who are so badly affected in this pandemic. We also pray for Israel, Lord. We pray especially, Father, for the peace of this nation. Lord, you have said in your word, Lord, you will bless those who bless Israel. Lord, tonight, this morning, Lord, we pray and we bless this nation, Father. We ask you, Lord, for protection and covering for this nation, and we pray, Lord, that the Jews will come to know you in a personal way, and they will look to you, Father, and surrender themselves to you, Father. We thank you for peace in that nation. We thank you for salvation to the people of Israel, Father. We give you all glory, Lord Jesus. Father, this morning we pray, even as your word is shared this morning, open our hearts and minds, Lord. And we pray especially, Lord, this message will cause each one of us to be motivated and challenged, Lord, to be a powerful blessing to others, Father. Truly, we want to be a channel of blessing to every person whom we come across, Father. Let your word speak to our hearts this morning, and let your name be lifted up. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. This morning, we just want to minister God's word, a very short message from my heart, and I trust that every one of you will receive that message and move on and respond to God. Now, I just want to read to you from a text from Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. Now, the Lord had said to Abraham, "Get out of your country, from your family and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you." Verse 2 says, "I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you, and in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed." I entitled my message this morning as Channels of Blessing. Channels of Blessing. Now, the scripture passage we just read in our text this morning is about the call of God upon Abraham's life. God called Abraham to leave his home and go to a particular place and to be a blessing to the nations, all right? Go away from his country, leave all his family members and everything else, and go to a particular place and be a blessing to nations. Now, the entire story of Abraham's life shows us that truly he was blessed by God, and he became a blessing to the nations, a blessing to the nations. Now, there are two important truths we can see in this portion which we have just read. And one is, God is the source of all blessings. And the second thing is, God wants and expects us to be a blessing. Now, God is the source of blessing. You know, when God called Abraham, he said, "I will bless you and make you into a great nation." Now, this shows that God is the source of all blessings. It's a fact that God is a source of all good things. Now, every blessing we receive day to day in our lives, we know is from God. Now, often we don't recognize the good hand of our God upon our lives, who is always constantly loading us with benefits. The psalmist says he loads us with benefits. Truly, our Lord God is always constantly loading us with benefits, blessing after blessing. But very often, we focus on the struggles and problems in our life, and we look at what we are experiencing, and we are looking to the negativity of all that we go through, and we forget the goodness and kindness of our God, who is always mindful of us. Now, everything we have today, our families, our business, our possessions, and our source of income, and all this is from God. Now, sometimes we think that our jobs, our business, and our accomplishments are because of our own effort. We fail to see that it's not just our own efforts. It is God who actually blesses us. Now, we don't realize it is Him who gives us the strength and the opportunities. Now, if He hasn't given you health and strength, how would you and I do the work we need to do and earn an income? It's health that is given by Him, all right? So if He hasn't given this strength and health, we will not be able to do anything for ourselves. And if He doesn't open up doors of opportunities for us, we will be lost, friends. Without the opportunities and doors that God opens, without it, we will be lost. Now, prosperity and riches come from the Lord. Yes, because it is Him who gives us power to make wealth. Now, so let's be reminded, friends, of the truth that God is the source of our life. All right? The second thing that is important for us to remind ourselves is God wants us and expects us to be a blessing. All right? In verse 2 of the text that we read, He said to Abraham, "I will make you a great nation," and then says, "I will bless you and make your name great," and finally says, "And you shall be a blessing." He says, "You shall be a blessing." Now, if God is the source of blessing, He also wants us to be a blessing. One important truth that we need to understand is a blessing is not for us to just for our selfish ambition or our selfish enjoyment, but it's intended to be shared, all right? So God blessed Abraham not to keep all the blessings to himself and to his family, but he must become a channel of blessing. Now, God blesses us, He blesses us because He's the source of blessing. And then we joyfully receive the blessing with thanksgiving. And then we intentionally need to bless others. And others who are blessed eventually become a blessing to others. All right? Now, this is how the cycle of blessing works. It's actually a cycle of blessing. When God begins to bless you, you bless others, and those people who are blessed eventually will bless other people. And this is how the cycle of blessing goes. Now, just for an example to give you, think about the Tanaga National, who provides for us, gives us electricity and power. Now, the power plant does not have the power or energy, but it has to generate the power. It has to generate the power. The same principle, friends, is applied when blessing is received, all right? And because blessing has to be generated. Blessing has to be generated. And as we generate blessings, we see more people begin to have that blessing and experience the blessing. Church, you and I are put in this world, in our lives here on this earth, for a purpose. For a purpose. Jesus Christ went to the cross to save us from our sin, and he forgave us of our sinful nature, and so that he could make us his children. We are, friends, his sons and his daughters. We are children who have been given life and life more abundantly. He has given us eternal life, all right? And he has revealed himself to be the personal Savior and Lord. So the Lord has bestowed upon us this blessing. What is this blessing? This blessing is the miracle of salvation. What a blessing, friends. You and I who are in sin, you and I who are roaming in, walking in sinful nature, in unrighteousness, we don't deserve it. But he went to the cross and he bought us, he redeemed us, and he gave us this blessing of the miracle of salvation. What a joy. What a joy and to be assured that we are blessed. We are people of blessing. We are blessed with this miracle of salvation. And now he says to us, like what he told Abraham, he said, and you shall be a blessing. Blessing to others so that they too can experience the living God and have the same assurance of eternal life that you and I have. All right. Now, the first thing I need you to know this morning is you are called to be a channel of blessing. Now, what does it mean to be a channel of God's blessing? Now, it simply means that God desires to use us, use me and you, as an instrument to serve and accomplish his purposes. All right? It's a desire. His desire, God's desire, is for the whole world to come to know him and to experience the reality of his power. Now, God's desire, friends, is to touch lives. God's desire is to set people free from the bondage of the devil. God's desire is to heal the sick. And God's desire is to bring peace to their hearts. To bring peace to their hearts. So, friends, you and I, we are called to be channel of blessing. We are supposed to bring peace to the hearts of the people who are troubled. We are the ones who are going to be used as instruments to pray and heal the sick. We are the ones who's going to come and deliver people of demonic possession. You and I are called to be a blessing because we have been blessed with the power of the living God. So why is this message of being a channel of blessing relevant for today? Why is it so relevant? Now, what we need to know, friends, is that we are living in perilous days. We are living in days where the entire world is going through suffering and troubled times. Now, people's hearts are restless, full of worry, full of anxiety. Family members are dying. Imagine you have family members in your family dying of COVID. Or imagine what kind of a heartache and sorrow that they would be going through. You know, family members dying of COVID. Many are grieving. Many are sorrowful due to the unexpected happenings that are taking place in these days. Now, many are struggling with financial burdens and with sleepless nights. Many people can't sleep and go to sleep. these sleepless nights, and people are dying without a hope, friends. People are dying without a hope and even trying to end their lives. God knows everything that is going on, and He is calling His redeemed people to arise and become channels of blessing. Friends, you and I need to touch somebody's heart. You and I need to touch somebody's heart with the gospel of peace. You can be a consolation or a comfort to those who are in a mental state of depression. Many people are emotionally troubled. You and I can put a word of comfort, put a word of peace from the word of God and comfort and strengthen them. You know, Galatians chapter 6 and verse 2 says, Galatians chapter 6 and verse 2, carry each other's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. In other words, if we are of Christ, we fulfill His law and by carrying each other's burdens and be a channel of blessing to people who are needy and suffering. So we need to recognize. We need to recognize other people's burden. We need to become so sensitive to the needs of other people. We are very, very sensitive to our own needs, our own problem, our own families. But it's time, church, the church of God, the people of God, become more and more sensitive to the needs of the people around us. Looking out to touch somebody and to be a blessing to someone. All right. The second thing is, we are God's agents. We are God's agents of change. God's agents of change. Now, people of God, we are empowered by the power of the Holy Spirit to touch lives who are physically and spiritually crippled. I'm sure you know this portion of the book of Acts. In Acts chapter 3, verses 1 to 8, is a very familiar portion. Here, what happens is, Peter and John, they went to the temple and they saw a certain lame man who was lame from the time he was born, from his mother's womb. And he was laid daily at the temple gate to receive alms from people who are going into the temple. Now, in the verse 4 of that portion says, fixing his eyes on him with John, Peter said, look at us, silver and gold I do not have, but what I have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankles, bones of the feet and ankles became strengthened. He received strength. And verse 8 says, so he leaping up, stood and walked and entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. Walking and leaping and praising God. Now, friends, this lame man who has never walked in his life, he was crippled physically, but much more than money, he needed an encounter with Christ. Much more than money. You know, God used Peter and John as his agents. He used Peter and John as his agents to touch this man's life. Now, he has been crippled for 40 years of his life. For 40 years of his life, he was crippled. But here, because of this, of God's agents, Peter and John, God manifested His miraculous power. God manifested His miraculous power through these agents of change. These agents of change. You and I are called to be agents of change. We can bring change to lives of people who are downtrodden. We can bring change to people who have no hope. We can bring change to people who have not come to know the joy and the peace of God. This means you and I, friends, who are called to be agents, we are able to touch lives and turn around situations of people. People who are depressed, bring them joy, bring them peace. So this man's life changed. This man's life completely changed. And then he went walking and leaping and praising God. Now, why does he praise God? Praising God because he has experienced the miraculous power of the mighty Lord Jesus Christ. The grace and power of God. He experienced the grace and power of God, and it brought change to his entire life. This man who was lame for 40 years, His life became changed because of God's agents, God sent to touch them. Hallelujah. You and I are God's agents to bring about change to the lives that are aimless. And those lives without hope, they're groping around in the dark without knowing where to go, what to do. And I want to tell you, friends, Christ is the answer. Christ is the answer to man's deepest need. We can try to give all kinds of counseling, all kinds of intellectual suggestions, but I want to tell you, nobody can touch the lives of people in the depths of the heart, but only Jesus Christ. He is the only way. He is the only answer to man's needs. So friends, let us take responsibility and remind ourselves that God has called us to be His agents, to be His instruments, to be a channel of blessing. There are times where people are not only physically sick, but emotionally disturbed. They need a touch of God. These emotionally disturbed people, they need the touch of God. Restless hearts need the peace of God. Everywhere, people are restless, do not know what's going to happen next. The uncertainty of their lives. People are restless. They need the peace of God. And people, friends, are looking out for spirit-filled agents. Spirit-filled agents so that you can go and counsel and pray for them. Now, Peter and John, you realize, they did not plan to meet this beggar, all right, and who needed a touch from God. Now, it wasn't in the agenda on that day, but it was in God's agenda that they would go to the temple at that time where this beggar would be sitting there with that great need. Now, here, it's an appointment that was so divine. It was a divine appointment. I believe, friends, there are many divine appointments in our own lives. We go through situations and we realize, oh, this is God appointed. God led me to do this. Because many things in our lives are divine appointments. And we may bump into strangers, all right, or even people in need, all right. These are not coincidences, but these are God's incidents where God leads us to them. God leads us to them. We cross paths because God caused it to happen. Because God caused it to happen, we somehow cross paths. Now, why? Because God loves them and they need Christ. Because God loves them and they need Christ. God wants to use us, friends. God wants to use us, His agents, to touch people and draw them towards Him. To draw them towards Him. You and I can do that. You have been saved, born again, spirit-filled. And you and I are the agents. Let's remind ourselves, we are agents of change. And let's rise up and do something in these days to the people among your relatives, among your members of the community. You can be a channel of blessing. The third thing is, become a channel of blessing in giving. Now, God is the source of all blessings, and blessings are meant to be shared. All right? Now, we are also given the privilege of not just praying for people or counseling, but to give generously. Now, giving your financial blessing to bless others who are actually going through genuinely deep needs in their finances. Now, two things happen when we give, all right? The first thing is, when we give with the right attitude, God reminds us that whatever we have is actually His. Whatever we have received from Him. So God reminds us that what we have is not really our own, all right? Now, He gives us everything we have. It all belongs to Him. Now, in 1 Chronicles chapter 29 and verse 14, King David prayed, in this portion, 1 Chronicles 29 and verse 14, King David prayed, he said, all things come from you, and of your own we have given you. That means we have given you what actually belongs to you. That's what he prayed, all right? All things come from you, and of your own we have given you. We need to learn this important truth, friends. Everything that we have belongs to him. It is him who has given it to us. Second thing we need to know when we give is, when we give, we help to meet the needs of others who God loves and cares also. All right? Now, our giving to others, we actually testify to God's love for them. We testify to God's love for them, and we point them to the greatest gift of all. The greatest gift of all is God's gift of His Son for our salvation. That's the greatest gift of all. So when we bless others financially, bless others with our counsel and prayer, we actually are pointing them towards the greatest gift of all, Jesus Christ, for our salvation. All right? We can let the people of God, people around, know, oh, that this is the blessing that we have, and we can impart this blessing to others. Now, someone has said, we as God's people should resemble channels and not reservoirs. Channels, but not reservoirs. Now, a reservoir stores water. You all know that, right? The reservoir stores water, but a channel distributes it. The channel distributes the water to different tributaries. All right? Here, God wants us to be channels of blessing to others. Wants us to be a channel of blessing to others. That means when we receive our blessing, we don't just store it and become a reservoir, but we become channels of blessing, distributing our blessings to people who are in need. Now, friends, I just want to remind all members of Harvest Revival Center, Harvest Revival Center needs to be a channel of blessing to our community. We are called to be channels of blessing to our community. Now, we need to start touching lives, even through our phone, through SMSs, even through our giving. All right? Now, one of the ways that you can have an opportunity to give towards as a channel of blessing is contributing towards our Agape Fund. We have a fund called the Agape Fund, and these funds are received from members and well-wishers, so that with this money, we can actually bless people financially for those who are really going through deep trouble with their financial burdens. You and I can be a channel of blessing. So this Agape Fund, if you'd like to know of how you can actually contribute to this Agape Fund, just watch closely on the screen for the when the announcement is on, and take it down and be a channel of blessing by giving towards this ministry. The fourth thing is God's requirement, faithful stewards. God requires us to be faithful stewards. God declares to Abraham, He says, nations will be blessed through you. Nations will be blessed through you. Now, this statement pictures a sense of responsibility, which is the part of Abraham. Now, God declares, and it is a part of responsibility for Abraham. God says He will bless the nations through Abraham's life. All right, He blessed Abraham so much, but God says He will bless the nations through his life. All right, just like how God wanted Abraham to become a faithful steward in carrying a great responsibility, people of God, you and I have got to take that responsibility. You and I have got to become faithful stewards and carry that responsibility of being channels of blessing. Channels of blessing. Proverbs chapter 24 and verse 1. It says, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. We own nothing. We own nothing. We are just stewards expected to be faithful to God's property entrusted to us. God, whatever God has given us, He has blessed us with everything. All right? We are supposed to be faithful stewards and to be responsible for what God has entrusted to us. He has entrusted life to us. He has entrusted life abundance. He has given us life eternal. He has entrusted to us. He has entrusted to us His Spirit that is within us as a guarantee that we are His children. With this, friends, we can bless others and become faithful stewards to make use of what we have been entrusted with. And finally, how can you daily be a channel of blessing? I just want to tell you three very basic things, and be reminded and flow with that and become a powerful channel of blessing. Firstly, how can you become daily be a channel of blessing? Firstly, refresh yourself daily with a quality time of fellowship with God. Quality time of fellowship with God, all right? Listening attentively to His specific instructions to you. You know, as you are serious and sincere with your quiet time talking to God and listening to God, you will begin to hear His voice. He will drop a word in your spirit, giving you instructions of what you need to do, how you can meet that need of another brother, how you can meet that need of another sister. He will give you the promptings in your heart. So refresh yourself daily with the quality time of fellowshipping with God. And secondly, release anything within you that could block the flow of blessing. Release anything within you that could block the flow. Release anything that displeases God. Anything that is kept within your heart. Sinful thoughts, unforgiveness. Release it. Release it. That the channel be so clear where the flow of the blessing of God can come upon you and through you. Prevent anything that could block the flow of God's blessings into your life and through your life. And thirdly, express your gratitude in action by freely giving. All right? In Matthew 10, chapter 10 and verse 8 says, a very familiar scripture, freely you have received, freely give. Freely you have received, freely give. And friends, God is love. Love reaches out. Love gives. Love makes a difference. You and I need to make a difference because we are of God and God is of love. God is love. And if God is within us, we need to reach out. We need to give. We need to make a difference in the place where we are planted. Wherever you are planted, be a blessing. Be a blessing to the people. You know, God's plan is always to extend His love to the world. God's plan, He always wants to restore life to people. All right? He calls us to be channels to restoring power. He is calling us to be a channel to channel His compassion, to channel His love, channel His healing to the people who are hurting, friends. There are people hurting everywhere. You and I, who have experienced the love of God, the passionate compassion of God, you and I got to rise up. We got to rise up and be a channel of blessing, touching lives. Wherever we meet people, with God's appointments, we need to touch lives. So let's remember, friends, you and I are called to be a channel of blessing. We are God's agents of change. You're called to change lives. And third, because you and I are called, we become a channel of blessing in giving. A channel of blessing in giving. And finally, God's requirement is just you and I becoming faithful stewards of the Lord. And as we daily refresh ourselves and walk with God and walk in intimacy with God, releasing anything that displeases God and express our gratitude in our freely giving, you will see you and I will become powerful channels of God's blessings. I just want to encourage each one of you, friends. If you have listened to this message, it's a simple, straightforward message. These are times, the relevancy of this message for these times that we're living in. People outside who do not know Jesus are looking out for something to hope for, something to cling on to. You and I are the agents who can touch them and turn them towards God, that they too can be blessed and they can be saved. I trust that you have received what God is speaking to you this morning. And I just want to close this morning. And I just ask each one of you to just close your eyes and receive this prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, that you are a good God and all good things come from you. And you are the source of all blessings. And truly we remind ourselves, Lord, this morning that you desire that we become channels of blessing, that we need to be blessing others. And God, we pray for each one of us who has listened to this message, Lord. Bring to our awakening within us, Lord, to recognize that you have called us to be a channel of blessing. Whether we are few years Christians or many years Christians, you have called us to be channels of blessing. And we pray, Lord, that every believer here will rise up and become God's channel of change, that we will desire in our heart to change lives towards you, Father. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that you will cause each one of us to become a channel of blessing in our giving. Lord, you said, Lord, that you love cheerful givers. We want to be cheerful givers, Lord, as people of God. And also, Lord, we pray that every believer will become faithful stewards. And you know, and we know, Lord, that you require that, Father. And we pray for every member of Harvest Revival Center and all those who are watching this virtually. We pray, God, that you will bless every one of them. Lord, let your abundant blessings flow upon each one of them, Lord, that they will multiply in the blessings and they will in turn be a powerful channel of blessing. Bless every one of them, Father. Lord, we thank you, God, for your word, and we pray that we want to live and run with your word. We ask all this in Jesus' precious name, and everybody say, Amen. Amen. God bless you. Have a great week.